Hi everyone, in today's video we're going to explore combination of two AWS services, recognition and translate inside a Lambda function. We'll go through everything step by step, starting with text extraction from an image using recognition, then translating that text into another language with translate. I've got a few example files in S3, some of them might be tricky to read. So I'm really curious to see how well AWS handles the text detection. Let's dive in and see how it works.
Create function. Function name, for example, OCR Lambda test. Latest Python. I select an existing role with the necessary permissions for S3 and recognition. Create function. First, I want to create a longer timeout. Go to configuration. Edit. Change, for example, for 5 minutes. Save. Go back to the code. Import bottle tree. First, I'm initializing the AWS Rekognition and S3 client. Bottle tree client recognition. And bottle tree client. Here I define the S3 bucket name and the image file that will be proceed. First, the image contains the text that we want to extract. Of course, you should use your bucket name and object key name. Let's go to S3. I'm going to use this bucket, recognition bucket. Let's go to OCR. As you can see, I have already prepared a few files. Go back to our function. Paste here bucket name. Object key. I added files to the OCR directory, so OCR. Let's go back to S3 and let's choose, for example, this file. Paste. Response. Recognition client. Detect text. Okay, in this step, I'm calling AWS Rekognition to detect text within the image stored in the S3 bucket. Image. S3 object. Bucket, and here we add our bucket. Name. Here we add our file. Okay, now I initialize a list that will hold all detected lines of text from the image. Here I loop through the text detection in the response. Each text detection contains information about the detected text. I check if the detected text is a full line. If it's a line, I add detected text to the list of detected lines. At this point, I combine all the detected lines into a single string, of course separating each line with a new line character. Now I create a new file name for the extracted text. I just add extracted text.txt to name of the new file. In this step, I upload the extracted text as a .txt file back to the same S3 bucket with UTF-8 encoding. This is the S3 bucket where the name file will be stored. This is the name of the new text file. I want to ensure that text is encoded at UTF-8 to support special character. In this step, specify UTF-8 charset in the content type. The function ends by returning a success message, letting us know that the original extracted text was saved successfully. Text extracted and save it as name of the new file. Deploy, test, invoke. Okay, let's fix this. Oh yeah. Deploy. Test. Oh yeah, success message. Text extracted and saved as OCR, name of the new file, and with extracted text.txt. Let's go to S3, refresh. Oh yeah, here we have new text file. Open. Yeah, it works. Okay, it works and we have the text extracted from the image. And it wasn't easy. Okay, let's go back to our code. Now, I want to add a few lines, thanks to which we will be able to translate this extracted text into any language. Now, I will call the Amazon Translate service to translate the extracted text. Photo 3, client, translate. The text will be translated from its original language, automatically detected, into Polish. Now I will call the Amazon Translate service to translate the extracted text. The text will be translated from its original language, automatically detected, into Polish. the original text extracted from the image, which we will now translate. Amazon Translate will automatically detect the source language. Target language is Polish. PL is the code for the Polish. Here I store the translated text that I received from the translation response. Now I create a new file name for the translated text. I just add translatepl.txt. Finally, I upload the translated text as another text file to the same S3 bucket with UTF-8 encoding. And the same S3 bucket will hold the translated text file, the new file name for the translated text. I want to ensure that translated text is encoded at UTF-8. And again, specify UTF-8 hard set in the content type.
Deploy. Test. Oh yeah, success message. Let's go to S3, refresh.
Yeah, we have our files. Extracted text and translated PL. Created almost at the same time, 1 second later than the other. So let's open the file with the translation of the text, read from the image and see how it works. Looks good. As a reminder, this is the text read in the original language, and this is the image we read from. Okay, let's go back to S3 and try the next image. Copy. Now I will just change the name. Deploy. Test. Okay, let's go to S3 and see what we've created. This is the extracted text. And this is translated. As you can see, special characters are written correctly, which is often a problem in translation, so it's worth paying attention to this. And let's check the last image. Copy. Deploy. Test. Okay, let's go to S3 and see what we've created. This is the extracted text. And this is translated.
Okay, thanks for your time and see you in the next episode. Bye.
Oh, of course, check my blog on lepczynski.it. You will find there a lot of tutorials that will show you how to use the AWS cloud and take you step by step to the next level. Thanks for